अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुतिस्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौघुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। बिगिनिंग दी विचार सागर टेक्स्ट क्वाइट एन एलाबोरेट टेक्स्ट टेक्स्ट बाय साधु निश्चल दास। सो साधु निश्चल दास वॉज एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स ही वॉज अ साधु। ही वॉज ऑल्सो पंडित फ्रॉम द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया। नॉट मच इज नोन। There is some speculation and scholars, researchers have found out that he was from area near Delhi. We'll not go into details about historical details about of the person, but he created a work which is quite elaborate, caters to different types of sadhakas as Moksha Shastra. It's a manana grantha and also covers multiple prakriyas. This work was originally in Avadhi Hindi with dohas, and there was a commentary either created by the sadhu himself or by his shishya varga. It is said that a great king also, perhaps in Rajasthan, he was a shishya of, he was a shishya of Sadhu Nishchala Das. This Hindi is difficult to understand even by those who know Hindi well. However, this Grantha has been translated in many languages, including one by Vasudev Brahmahendra Saraswati Swamiji. You see, this work in Sanskrit is not only a translation by Swamiji, who is the author of the other Shastras also written here. I'll increase the size of the screen once we go ahead on other pages. But this Swamiji from the Kanchi Sampradaya, he came across this work. He learned Hindi to translate this work and made a Sanskrit Vichara Sagara. So this Grantha that we are going to study is called Sanskrit Vichara Sagara, in which Swamiji has added a lot of his own to cater to the Shruti Pramana. Because generally in the Sampradaya, when you do a Nirdharana of something or you express something, then a support has to be given from Shruti. This Shruti support or Smriti support or other Pramana was not given elaborately by the Sadhu. So this Sanskrit Vichara Sagara is more exhaustive than the original Hindi work. Further, this work is in prose. It has very less Padya, it has more Gadya. We look at the Moola because the Doha in Sanskrit, in Hindi, sorry, the Hindi original Dohas, meaning the Padya, as well as the Gadya commentary, was translated in Sanskrit, which has become the Moola in Vichara Sagara. There is also a Tippani. We will not go through Tippani. Tippani is quite exhaustive as well, but it is not like prose. These are just, single points. Considering that the work is quite exhaustive, it's going to be several months, definitely more than a few months, even if we do on a daily basis. We'll see how much we can do. I'll do Yathashakti, and the purpose is to study it as Moksha Shastra. I'll not be able to give scholarly details, so I may kindly be excused for that. There's quite an elaborate introduction also. We'll skip all that and go to the beginning of the text. There's an elaborate contents list also, which itself gives what is the arrangement of the book and what is the arrangement of each part, each section, each chapter of the book. So the division of the work is such that you have, first of all, it is called Vichara Sagara. Sagara means ocean. Vichara is thinking or contemplation. So it's an ocean of contemplation. In this ocean of contemplation, the chapters are called as tarangas, meaning waves. And in each chapter, in each wave, there are avartas, sections. Avartas are ripples. So you have Vichara Sagara divided into waves, and those waves are divided into ripples, the sections. And each section has a Purva Paksha also. There is Samadhana, so Akshepa and Samadhana, along with some details in the Tippani. This is the arrangement of the book. You see, let me go through the print as to where it starts. I forgot to mark the page number in the PDF. There are seven tarangas or seven chapters in this book. And since Upanishads are also mostly dialectics, this book also is arranged in such a manner that there's a dialectic, there's a story of a king and his three sons, which you'll get to. And each son has a different qualification. Kindly mute yourself and switch off the cameras if possible. So there's a listing of words. There are typos in the end of the section on contents. So this is errata. After the errata, it starts at, so 100 pages of errata in a 479 page book, and the work proper starts here. As you can see, it is called Sanskrita Vichara Sagara. So there's an initial Mangalacharana by the translator, and then there is the Mangalacharana of the original author. This is the original author's Mangalacharana. We'll do the Mangalacharana of the Sanskrit Vichara Sagara, and then we'll do the Mangalacharana of the Hindi Vichara Sagara, and daily we'll follow this. विल डू दी मंगलाचरण बोध दी मंगलाचरण श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यम श्री वासुदेव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सरस्वती विरचित संस्कृत विचार सागर दी ओनली मंगलाचरण दैट ही डज इज श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यम सो नमः हुम इज द नमस्कार नमः गवर्न्स फोर केस सो श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय श्रीयुक्त चिद्घन चित्त इज कॉन्शियसनेस एंड घन इज होमोजिनियस अनडिवाइडेड टू दैट काइंड ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस विच अपियर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ गणेश टू दैट गणेश माय नमस्कार नाउ विद द नमस्कार टू गणेश There is another word in Samanadhikaranam which is Mahiyam. Asmad, Asmad Shabda. To me who is Chidghana, I who am in the form of consciousness, homogeneous consciousness, who appears in the form of Ganesha. And this Mahiyam is the Tvampada Laksharatha. It is not me with the body, mind, sense complex. It is the Shuddha Chaitanya. So the Shuddha Chaitanya, which is me, who am also in the form of Ganesha. To that Ganesha, my Namaskara. So you can see in the beginning itself, what kind of work is this? It does not divorce itself from the Aikya. Starts with the Advaita Tattva itself in the Mangalacharana. Further, Tadiyaya Tippanya. समंगलकृतः तत्र अनुबंधानां सामान्यतः निरूपणं नाम प्रथमस्तरंगः दि फर्स्ट तरंग और दि फर्स्ट चैप्टर स्टार्ट्स विद व्हाट इट स्टार्ट्स विद दि मंगलाचरण बट व्हाट इज सेड हियर इट इज रिक्वेस्ट टू यू काइंडली जॉइन बिफोर दि Class starts. I purposely join in 2-3 minutes late so that everyone has logged in because especially this Google Meet has an issue with I have to allow each person to enter. Thereby, it takes a little while. I have to switch from the flow of the class and allow people in. So kindly try to join in before the class begins. 2 minutes before is fine. Log in before 2 minutes of the class, if possible. Otherwise, I'll have to stop and switch. It disturbs the class. So, tatra anubandhanam samanyatah nirupanam nam pratamas taranga. The first taranga, first chapter, the wave here, literally, but in Sagara, it's a wave, but in the text, it is a chapter. The first chapter is what? Tatra anubandhanam, the anubandha chatushtaya, vishaya adhikari, Phala, Prayojana and Sambandha between them. This is the Anubandha Chaturthaya. So, Anubandhanam Samanyataha Nirupanam. Generally, they are described in the first chapter. There, what is the Mangalacharana? Vastu Nirdesha Rupa Mangalacharanam. There are multiple types of Mangalacharana. Mangalacharana can be a prayer. It can be in the form of Ashirvada. It can be Paikya Rupa. Here, like Vastu Nirdesha. Vastu is Vasatiti Vastu. Brahma alone is really existent. That is called as Vastu. And Vastu Nirdesha Rupa Mangalacharanam. Mangalacharana, which is usually done for two purposes, main purposes. One, for the completion of the text. Let the text get completed, whatever the author is composing. Second, it should have a reach. It should survive and have a reach to the intended audience. So Mangalacharana is done for that purpose. It could have been any kind of Mangalacharana. Like Ganeshaya Namaha. But Mahiyam shows that Vastu is being talked about, which is Chid. So it is not Ganesha in the form of Ganesha. It is not a Saguna मंगलाचरण, इट इज अ मंगलाचरण ऑफ द निर्गुण हु अपीयर्स एज सगुण. सो अभेद बिटवीन द सगुण एंड निर्गुण हैज बीन शोन बाय द संस्कृत विचार सागर ऑथर. ऑल्सो ऐक्य बिटवीन द समष्टि एंड व्यष्टि हैज बीन शोन बाय एडिंग मह्यम टू मी, नमस्कार टू मी हु इज चिदघन. सिमिलरली हियर वस्तु निर्देश रूप मंगलाचरण ऑफ द ओरिजिनल ऑथर साधु निश्चल दास. वस्तु निर्देश रूप which points out the vastu brahma, that kind of mangalacharana is being done, which is jiva brahmaikya rupa mangala, mangalam in the form of aikya between jiva and brahma, vyashti and samashti. There are two verses, sukham nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namarupayoho adhisthanam buddhyabodhyam buddher drugyattu nirmalam अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यद् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. इन द टू वर्सेस साधु सेस सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानम्, अधिष्ठान ऑफ नाम एंड रूप. एंड सुखा इज आनंद स्वरूप, नित्या इज सत्स्वरूप, स्वप्रकाश इज चित्त स्वरूप. सो सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म इज कवर्ड हियर. सत नित्या चित स्वप्रकाश एंड सुख आनंद, सच्चिदानंद रूप ब्रह्म. वाई इज इट स्वप्रकाश? चैतन्य. बट स्वप्रकाश shows that it has no dependency on anything else. Every other namarupatmaka jagat has dependency on Brahma for its satta and spurti. However, Brahma does not have any dependence. The karyatmaka jagat, the jagat which is a karya product, has its dependency on the karana. There is no other satta. The satta that you see, the existence of the product, is borrowed from the karana, from the cause. If you remove the cause, there is no existence of the product. If you remove gold from the bangle or from a necklace or an earring, then there is no existence for a gold bangle, the gold earring, and the gold necklace. Similarly, karana removed from the pot, from a clay pot, clay removed, the pot cannot exist. So the existence of the pot is really the existence of the clay. But Brahma does not have any dependency on anything else for its satya, satta. Therefore, it is nitya, trikalabhadita sat, ever existent, not like a product which has its existence borrowed only when it is born, created, and when it is unmanifest or destroyed, that time the product goes away. So it is no longer nitya. This is unlike that. This is has its own satta. Then you see sentient beings everywhere. These sentient beings have sentience, but the sentience is not their own. The sentience is also borrowed. It is borrowed from its karana, which is the paramakarana or the sarvakaranaanam karana, the karana of all karanas is Brahma. That Brahma is swaprakasha. It has its original consciousness, which is borrowed by the products where it can manifest. Those in the jagat which have antakkarana, where the consciousness can reflect, where the bimba chaitanya can reflect as pratibimba chaitanya, there alone sentience is manifest. The consciousness is manifest as sentient. Others remain insentient, although there is an underlying satta as well as spurti. Not only satta, we say the ghata asti, pata asti, but we don't talk about chaitanya of ghata and chaitanya of pata. still the chaitanya is underlying. The only thing is that it cannot manifest in the ghatapata because there is antakkarana lacking, sukshma sharira is lacking. But in animals, birds, human beings, devatas, rakshasas, insects, in all of those, antakkarana is there where the consciousness can reflect. Thereby, there is a possibility of sentience. But that sentience which is reflected is not its own sentience, it is a borrowed sentience. But in Brahma, it is Swaprakasha because it does not need any other Chaitanya to show itself. A human being knows that I exist because he is conscious. A human being knows that I am conscious also because of that consciousness. That Swaprakasha Sakshi Rupa Chaitanya is what Brahma is. And Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham shows the Swarupa of Brahma Satchidananda. That is a Vyapaka Tattva that alone manifests as the Prapancha, taking Nama Rupa. So Vyapakam, it is all pervasive because it is Karana of even Akasha. Akasha is all pervasive. Even Nayayikas agree that Akasha is one and it is all pervasive. That Akasha's Karana is Brahma. Tasmadva etasmad atmana akasha sambhutaha akashad vayuhu vayo ragnihi. So Taittiriya mantra says that from that Brahma, which is this Atma, Akasha was first born, manifest, which is Vyapaka, which is all pervasive, which exists everywhere. There cannot be anything unless there is space. Even before creating Vayu, Akasha had to be created in the Srishti Krama. And that Akasha is so Vyapaka and so Sukshma, Brahma is Karana of that Akasha, it has to be Vyapaka. So to that Vyapaka Brahma, there is no Nama mentioned here, but that is the Vyapaka Tattva, which is Brahma, Satchitananda Brahma. And when it manifests in the form of Nama Rupa, it becomes the Adhishthana. Because Nama Rupa manifestation is actually, it is available to transact as with Nama and Rupa. It is available to be cognized by the sense organs. But Brahma itself is not really cognized. It is a bhranti to see something as existent, whereas only Brahma is existent. So Nama is what? It is Vacharambha. Every karya is only begun with a name. The clay becomes a pot only by giving it a name and form. You separate out which does not have a name by giving a name. If they have the same form also, you can separate by separating the name. So division is created by name. Division where the name is same, it is created by form. If the form and name are same, we cannot differentiate. Even among twins, if twins are born, they may have similar form, but the parents don't give them the same name. One will be Rama, the other is Shama. One is Gita, other is Sita. Why? Because you want to differentiate. The division is created only with name and form. The Vyapaka Tattva Brahma cannot be divided otherwise. Satchidananda or Satyam Jnanam Anantam or Astibhati Priya, however you call it, it's the same thing which cannot be divided. It is Swarupa. It's a singular, homogeneous, indivisible entity. The only entity which is existent lends itself to division when you add a name or form. So those who have same forms like twins can be differentiated by name, Nama. If there are two names, if there are people with sharing the same name, how do you differentiate? By Rupa. You say, okay, this Rama or that Rama. So you differentiate by, oh, that Rama who carries a Parshu or that Rama who carries a Bana. धनुष्यबाण, सो यू डिफरेंशिएट बेस्ड ऑन सम काइंड ऑफ अ चेंज इन फॉर्म और एक्सेसरीज. सो नाम रूप इज द रीजन फॉर डिवीजन इन ब्रह्मा, बट द डिवीजन इज नॉट रियल, इट इज मिथ्या. देर बाय वॉट इज द अधिष्ठान, अधिष्ठान इज ब्रह्म. सो अधिष्ठानम सुखम नित्यम स्वप्रकाशम व्यापकम अधिष्ठानम, कयो हो अधिष्ठानम नाम रूपयो हो, इट इज द अधिष्ठान ऑफ नाम एंड रूप. फर्दर बुद्धि अबोध्यम, बुद्धि अबोध्यम मीन्स इट इज नॉट एक्सेसिबल टू बुद्धि. वाय? बिकॉज इट इज अ विटनेस, साक्षी, दृक्, बुद्धेर दृक्, इट इज अ द्रष्टा. ब्रह्मा इटसेल्फ इज अ साक्षी ऑफ दैट बुद्धि ऑल्सो. Therefore, buddhi cannot cognize it. Cognize it means in a sense, it cannot objectify it. It cannot objectify it. It has to be understood only by lakshana. Brahma is not vachyartha of even the Brahma shabda. It is not the vachyartha of sukha, nitya, swaprakasha, vyapaka, adhisthana. It is not a vachyartha of any of these words. बुद्धि के नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दिस अनलेस देर इज लक्षणा डन. इट इज नॉट दी कारण ऑल्सो, इट इज दी कारण रहित कारण विच ऑल्सो हैज नो कार्य रियली. देर बाय वन हैज टू इंक्वायर इन टू दी नेम ऑल्सो विच दी श्रुति गिव्स टू ब्रह्म. ब्रह्म इज फ्रॉम ब्रह्मवृद्धौ धातु which is limitless because it is not having any visheshana to qualify and limit it. That kind of brahma is limitless. An infinite tattva cannot be objectified by a limited mind or a buddhi. So it is abodhya, it is not buddhi visheya really, but it is only available to buddhi as well. Although it is not directly objectifiable by buddhi, it can be understood by the lakshyartha. So lakshyartha will tell you what is the real tattva, reality tattva. Therefore buddhi abodhyam and sakshi, druk is in the sense of sakshi here, buddher druk. Buddhi is manifest and I know. If I am an intellectual then I know that I am an intellectual. I know that I know. I know whether I have understood, whether I am lacking in understanding, I know. Therefore, I objectify the buddhi also. So, buddher druk. Look at this, starting from sukham nityam swaprakasham. Sukha can be anubhava siddha, may not be anubhava siddha. It is described in the shruti. Adhisthana is described in the shruti. So, this is the tatpadartha. But buddhi druk, buddhi is at the individual level. So from samashti level, he has come to the vyashti level, individual also. And saying he is the drashta of buddhi, I am the drashta of buddhi. Therefore, jiva brahma aikya is shown here. That brahma which is sachidananda rupa manifests the entire prapancha of nama rupa is also the druk of buddhi. Thereby, Vyashti is described here, the Jiva Swarupa, Sakshi Rupa Jiva. This Jiva Atma, Brahmatma, is Sakshi only as long as there is Saksha. Only as long as there is something to witness, one can be called as a witness. As soon as you know that the witnessed is Mithya, then the Sakshi name can also be dropped. You no longer are a witness. Thereby, you have to do Lakshana even there. Satchidananda Rupa Brahma manifests as a Sakshi as long as there is Saksha. If one mixes up with the Saksha, one becomes the Jiva who is limited. But really, even while mixing with the Sharira, Panchakosha, one remains free from the doshas of the sharira, therefore nirmala. Brahma at the level of samashti as Ishvara and at the level of vyashti as jiva, that brahmatma is nirmala, is shuddha. This is the first prayer which has not ended. Only with the second there will be an anvaya. Aparam, also aparam. Aparam sagara, which is shoreless. It's an infinite. Purnatvam is indicated by apara. Sarva Vedanta Vedyam. Neuter, therefore Vedyam. It is Sarva Vedanteshu Vedyam. Sarva Vedanteshu Yat Vedyam Tad Brahma Eva. Whatever is to be known, or yogya to be known, fit to be known, ought to be known, is a Parama Purushartha, and knowing which one will know everything, moksha sadhana, jnana being moksha sadhana, jnanena moksha, therefore jnana yogyam, that Brahma is described in all Upanishads, sarva vedanteshu vedyam, that is pratyak, pratyangatma. Pratyagatma is at the vyashti level, in each and every individual, whether it is human being or pakshi, pashu, it is manifest there, which is param, the most superior, and mahaha, the mahatattva, not mahatattva of the sankhyas, but mahatattva, which is really the brihatattva. Tadeva aham, that sukhanitya svaprakasha vyapaka adhishthana buddhya bodhya buddhehe druk sakshi nirmala tattva, which is apara, sarva vedanteshu vedya, and innermost to everyone, every jiva, which is the most superior and expansive, that I am. Tadeva aham, namatta anyat iti me nishchita matihi. Matya, matta anyat, other than me there is nothing else. Ahameva asmi, sarvam nasti ahameva asmi, bada samanali karanyam. Elsewhere talked about as bada samanali karanyam, sarvam khalvidam brahma. That brahma is atma. So brahma asti, when one understands tattvamasi, one knows that brahma asmi, aham asmi. Then sarvam khalu idam brahma, everything is this brahma, all this. Idam sarvam brahma. There, Brahma can be replaced by Aham. That is what Bhagavan Nishchaladas has done here. Tadeva Aham, Tad Brahma Eva Aham, thereby Sarvam Nasti. Aham Eva Asmi, Brahma Eva Asti, but after Sakshatkara, Aham Eva Asmi. Thereby Matta Anyat Kinchidapi Nasti. Matta Anyat Na. Na means Matta Anyat. Kinchidapi nasti, that is the idea here. Iti me mati nishchitaha, nishchita matihi. My understanding is of that level. So jnani lakshana, iti me nishchita matihi. You see this in Manisha Panchakam also. That dhridamati, nishchitamati, iti manisha mama. That is the jnani lakshana. He is not parroting what Shastra says. He says, I have conviction. Nishchita, manana siddha and nididhyasana siddha after shravana. This is the prayer. Now this prayer is to Brahma, who is Atma. Therefore, jiva Brahma aikya rupa mangala, which is also vastu nirdesha rupa mangala charana. It shows what is the vastu. Vyakhya says, asya arthastu tadeva aham iti uktya mahavakyartha pratyag abhinna paramatma eva swaswarupam iti. What is the Mangalacharana saying? It is showing jiva brahma aikya. So asya artha, what is the meaning here? Tadeva aham. By saying tadeva aham in the first quarter, first pada of the second verse, iti uktya, due to this, mahavakyartha pratyag abhinna paramatma eva swaswarupam iti. My nature is, jiva nature is same as that which is taught in the Mahavakya, like Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, Ityadi. That Pratyagatma is Abhinna from Paramatma. Pratyag Abhinna Parma. Paramatma Swarupa is same as Atma. So, Pratyag Abhinna Paramatma. not Paramatma who is sitting elsewhere in Vaikuntha or Kailasa. This Paramatma is not of the other religions also, if they have a concept of God. We have, Advaitins have a concept which is revealed as the Shruti does, without any preconcluded notions. The Shruti reveals Tattvamasi. Thereby, the Paramatma, the Lord or God of Advaitins, is not someone who is different from the innermost self for each and every being. Therefore, Pratyeka Bhinna Paramatma, that is the Swarupa, by saying Tadeva Aham. Tad Visheshanani Nirupyante. What are the Visheshanas of this Aha Aham? Who is that me? So now the description is, who am I really? Nirupyante tat pratyak param mahaha brahma. That me, aham, is pratyak, innermost self, not with the sharira. Discarding the sharira as mithya, cognitively, one is landing on the param brahma, which is pratyak brahma. The param maha is brahma, bruhi vriddho, brahat, mahat or brahat is same, has the same meaning. That param brahma is really me, which is the innermost self, which is kosha rahita, without any sharira. Katham bhutam further, what kind of me am I? What kind of param brahma is me? Is my nature? Sukham, nityam, swaprakasham, vyapakam. There is a typo here, vyapakam. Nama rupayoho, another typo. Nama rupayo adhishthanam cha bhavati. Punascha tad brahma katham bhutam buddhya bodhyam buddhehe drakcha bhavati. It is inaccessible to the buddhi as directly objectifiable, but it is available for lakshana. Further, buddheer druk, it is a sakshi, it can objectify the buddhi. Buddhi cannot objectify it, but it can objectify the buddhi. The buddhi works as buddhi due to my presence, Satchidananda presence in close proximity. How? With tadatmya sambandha really. Asya artha, what is the meaning of all this visheshanas which have been added? Buddhya bodhyam is nahi buddhi hi brahma vijanati na prakasheti ityartha. Buddhi does not objectify brahma directly, it cannot objectify brahma. Why? Shruti is quoted here, naiva vachana manasa praptum shakyo na chakshusha. So Katha Upanishad say vachana praptum shakyaha, manasa na va praptum chakshakyaha, chakshusha nava vaptum shakyaha. Brahma is not accessible to vagendriya. This is showing vagendriya is the karmendriya. So it's an upalakshana for all karmendriyas. Brahma is not accessible to any karmendriya. So it is not a prapti, it is not real prapti. Only apraptasya prapti is possible by karma. Apraptasya prapti karmana bhavati. This is apraptasya prapti karmana bhavati. So vak is karmendriya, upalakshana. It indicates any karma. Through any karma, any karmendriya, thereby karmendriya is used to do karma. It is not accessible through any karma. How about upasana? Can you do upasana? Na manasa praptum shakya. Through upasana, it is not attainable. Therefore, mind, manas, here is also upalakshana for buddhi. Thereby, buddhi brahma na vijanati na prakashayati. So, manasa praptum na shakya. What about chakshusha? Chakshusha, this is also chakshu is upalakshana for jnanendriya. It is not accessible to jnanendriya also. Yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasasa. So Taittiriya Brahmana says this, yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasasa. Upanishad also is in the Brahmana. So Taittiriya Upanishad also says that. Yatha yasmad vachaha, yasmad brahmana. Yatha is panchami, yasmad vachaha nivartante manasasaha. Manasasaha nivartante apraapya. Apraapya nivartante. Without attaining that brahma, which is me, really my swarupa, the vak as well as manaha written, na tatra suryo bhati, in katha as well as in, you have it in mundaka also, tatra surya na bhati. This bhati here is na bhaseti tyartha, does not, na prakasheti, does not light up, as in does not show the presence of the light of the surya. Surya, which makes the entire prapancha visible, is visible due to me, due to Brahma, Brahmatma. So it cannot shine and show Brahma. What you see in the entire prapancha as sentient and existent is the body-mind sense complex. You don't see the mind also. You infer the mind, you infer the sentience. But you cannot really infer, you cannot really objectify Sat and Chit directly. Sharira can be objectified. Similarly, the Surya shows up the bodies, but not the Satchidananda Vastu. Therefore, Tatra Surya na Bhati. Ityadi Shruti Bhyaha. Due to these Shrutis, multiple have been quoted. And then further, Kintu Buddher Druk. This we'll see in the next part of. Usually I have a 1 hour class, but this will be a 45 minutes because I have something else coming up. So we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part tomorrow with Kintu Buddher Druk. Sukham Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakam Namarupayo Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Druk Yattu Nirmalam Aparam Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevaham Namatto Anyat Iti Menishchitamatihi Tatsat. So I'll see you in the next part, huh? Namaste.
Hari Om.